Graph paper notebooks are one of the best-selling low content books on Amazon, and online design tools like Canva make it easier to create them for Amazon KDP beginners. Although there are many popular YouTube tutorials on how to make grid paper or graph paper in Canva, I am surprised that none of them shows how to control the exact scale of the grids. Since graph paper is used to create graphs, charts, and other visual representations of data, there are some industry standards like 4 squares per inch, 5 squares per inch, or 2 squares per inch. Therefore, if you want to call your low content book a real graph paper notebook to sell on Amazon, you have to care about the scale of the grids on your graph paper to accommodate different customer needs. If you want to learn how to make better graph paper in Canva and control the scale of the grids like a pro, keep watching till the end. Since it is not so complicated to make graph paper with different design tools, if you check graph paper notebook 8.5 by 11 on Amazon, there are 2000 results for this search term. However, if you niche down like graph paper notebook 8.5 by 11, 4 squares per inch, there are 372 results for this search term. It means less competition. As you see, controlling the scale of the grids not only makes your graph paper better, but also reduces the competition. So, let's make a graph paper notebook 8.5 by 11, 4 squares per inch in Canva. Firstly, I will open an 8.625 by 11.25 inch custom size blank documents. Since I would like to have lines extend to the edge of the page, I need this document with bleed margins. There is a chart in the KDP Help Center about the page sizes with and without bleed size information. You can check it for different trim sizes when you need it. So, my blank document is ready now. If you watch my previous video about Canva, I showed how to control the vertical space between the horizontal lines. I will follow the same methodology in this tutorial. First, use the keyboard shortcut L and make the line thinner. Then, click the circles on the edges and drag them to the edge of the page. After that, select the line and click position on the top menu. Change the start and end Y coordinate to 0 inch here to make the calculations easier. This will move our line to the 0 inch of Y coordinate, and this line will be our top horizontal line. Next, use the Ctrl-D shortcut to duplicate the line and align it to the first one using the pink guidelines. We will now make a small calculation. Our target is to make 4 squares per inch graph paper, so we need 0.25 inch spacing between the horizontal lines. The height of our paper is 11.25 inches. If we divide 11.25 by 0.25, we get 45. This means that we can place 46 horizontal lines on this paper. Since 11.25 is divisible by 0.25, our bottom line's Y coordinate should be 11.25 inches. Select the second line and click position on the top menu. Change the start and end Y coordinate to 11.25 inch. This line will be our bottom horizontal line. Now, we need to have 44 more lines between these two. So, select the top line and press Ctrl-D 44 times. Once you have done this, use the shortcut Ctrl-A to select all and click center in the position menu. Then, under the position menu, click vertically to space all the horizontal lines evenly between the top and the bottom line. If you press the Alt key, you will see that the space is 0.25. which is perfect. Finally, use the Ctrl-G shortcut to group them. You can drag the group anywhere on the artboard. Move it to the middle. Then, since we will draw vertical lines on it, it's better to right-click and lock the horizontal lines. Let's add the vertical lines now. Use the keyboard shortcut L to draw a line and make it thinner. Then, click position on the top menu. Rotate it to 90 degrees and change the start and end X coordinates to 0 inches here to make the calculations easier. After that, click the circles on the edges and drag them to the edge of the page. This line will be our left side vertical line. Next, select the line and use the Ctrl-D shortcut to duplicate the line and align it to the first one by using the pink guidelines. We will now make a small calculation. Our target is to make 4 squares per inch graph paper, so we need 0.25 inch spacing between the vertical lines. The width of our paper is 8.625 inches. If we divide 8.625 by 0.25, we get 34.5. This means that we can place 35 vertical lines on this paper. Since 8.625 is not divisible by 0.25, our right side line's x coordinate should be 34 times 0.25 equals 8.5 inches. Select the second vertical line and click position on the top menu. Change the start and end x coordinate to 8.5 inches. This line will be our right side vertical line. Now we need to have 33 more lines between these two. So select the left side line and press Ctrl D 33 times. Once you have done this, select the vertical lines and click middle in the position menu. Then, under the position menu, click horizontally to space all the vertical lines evenly between the left side and the right side lines. If you move the below horizontal lines and press the Alt key, you will see that the space is 0.25, which is perfect. Let's move the horizontal lines back to the center. Finally, select the vertical lines and right-click to group them. Then, move it to the center with the help of pink guidelines. Okay, our graph paper, 8.5 by 11, 4 squares per inch, is ready now. To control the scale of the grids, you can create a 0.25 by 0.25 inch square. To do this, click the elements on the left menu. Then click square under the shapes. After that, click position on the top menu. Change the width and height to 0.25 inches. Now let me zoom in a little bit to show you. As you can see, all our grid scale seems equal and accurate. By the way, I shared a free graph paper notebook 8.5 by 11, 4 squares per inch in one of my previous videos. You can find this file in my Creative Fabrica store. If you want to download it free, there is a link below in the description. If you like the video, please do not forget to like and comment. Thus, the YouTube algorithm recommends this video to more people like you. Thanks for watching. See you soon.